Hello everyone. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use the digital input of the Arduino board. In our circuit, we're going to use two components, a button and a switch, to control an LED illumination. I'm going to detail the whole process of programming and assembling of the two components. And I'm going to talk about the pull-up resistor, which is an important component in the circuit. In the end, we are going to control the LED illumination by using a button like I'm showing here. So, let's get started. Okay. Before we go to the programming, I'll show you how to assemble the circuit for a switch and for a button in the right way. So, up here, we have the symbol of the switch that we have in Tinkercad. We can see that the switch has three terminals, represented here by these yellow dots. Down here, I'm showing only the terminals of the switch, which are the ones we're going to make the connections. So, what we do with the switch is, we usually connect the left pin of the switch on the ground pin, which represents a low level, or 0 volts. And on the pin on the right, we connect the 5 volts. The middle pin of the switch is called the common terminal because when the switch is on the left, we are connecting the left terminal to the middle one, which in this case will transfer the low-level signal to the middle terminal. On the other hand, looking at the same configuration, but with the switch on the right, we are connecting the 5 volts to the middle terminal. Based on that, the common terminal is always connected either to the left terminal or to the right terminal. In summary, the switch will always have two well-defined signal levels. It's going to be 0 if it's on the left, or it's going to be 5 volts if it's on the right. Now, let's understand how we assemble the circuit using a button. The button has only two terminals and a metallic contact, which is pressed on the top. When the button is not pressed, there is no current flow or connection between the left terminal and the right terminal. When the button is pressed, the metal contact connects these two terminals. By pressing it, we have a current flow from the left terminal to the right terminal. Before showing how to assemble the circuit of a push button correctly, I'm going to show you a common mistake that people make during the assembly of the circuit. That is the circuit shown on the screen. In this configuration, one of the pins of the button is connected to 5 volts, and the other terminal is connected to the digital input of the Arduino. The problem of doing that is the following. When the button is not pressed, I don't have any signal on this pin. It doesn't necessarily mean that I have 0 volt on the pin, because this pin can capture interference from other equipment nearby, and then the signal will be different from 0. So, we don't know, by using this configuration, what is the voltage level on this pin. On the other hand, when I press the button, I'm connecting this pin to the pin on the right, and therefore, I'm transferring 5 volts to the Arduino board. The right way to assemble the circuit is through this configuration here. In this configuration, we are going to connect the 5 volts on a resistor, and the other terminal of the resistor, we are going to connect on the button terminal. And the other terminal, we are going to connect on the ground. This configuration is called pull-up resistor. The signal that goes to the Arduino board comes from this point here. Let me now explain how does this circuit work. When the button is not pressed, I don't have a current flow through the resistor. As I don't have a current flow, the voltage difference on the terminals of the resistor must be the same. Then, on this point, we have 5 volts. This is the situation when the button is not pressed. On the other hand, when we press the button, the ground level is transferred to the input of the Arduino. So, to recap, when the button is not pressed, we have 5 volts on the input, and when it is pressed, we have 0 volt on it. Now, let's go to the programming part of our circuit. Firstly, before we start with the programming, let's assemble our circuit on the breadboard. I've already made the connections of the LED. I've made the connection of the 5 volts of the Arduino board with this line here. And the ground level is connected on this line here. We are going to use the LED because our intention is to control the LED illumination using a switch and also a button. We connected the anode of the LED on the Arduino board. And the cathode goes on a resistor, which is connected on the ground. So, let's get our switch to put it on the breadboard. And let's make the circuit of the switch. As I showed previously, I'm going to connect the left pin of the switch on the ground level. Let's leave the wire in black color. And the right terminal of the switch, we are going to connect it on the 5 volts. Let's leave the wire in red color. And the middle terminal is going to be connected on pin 13. Okay. Now, I'm also going to assemble the button circuit with the pull-up resistor. We are going to connect terminal on the right, on the ground. And the other terminal, we are going to connect on the pull-up resistor. Let me get it here. And I'm going to connect it here. The resistor is connected on the 5 volts. And the connection of the button with the resistor is going to be connected on pin 12. Let's leave the wire with green color. So, in our project, we're going to use the switch and the button in two different steps to control the LED illumination. Now, let's go to our code. The first thing we are going to do is to define the pins on which our devices are connected. We are going to call the LED pin as pin LED, which is connected on pin number 8. We are also going to name the pin that is connected to the switch as pin switch, which is connected on pin 13. And, finally, we are going to name the pin that is connected to the button as pin BTN, which is pin 12. Okay. Now, in the void setup, we are going to define whether the pins are going to be an input or an output by using the function pin mode. The function pin mode has two parameters. The first parameter is the pin number that I'm going to set. Let's start with the LED pin. And this pin is going to be a digital output, which is the second parameter of the pin mode function. The second command is for the switch. It's going to be a digital input, just like the button. And then, we have the button configuration, which is going to be a digital input as well. Now that we've already configured the components that we're going to use in our circuit, let's go to the loop function of the code. Firstly, we're going to develop the programming logic for the switch. To do that, we're going to use the conditional if. Within this conditional, we're going to use the digital read function. This function has a single parameter, which is the pin that I configured as digital input, which in our case is the pin switch. This function returns a Boolean value that can be true or false based on the signal the pin is sending to the Arduino. So, if the signal I am sending is 5 volts, the function will return true as result. And if I'm sending 0 volt, it's going to return the value false. Considering this logic, I can type digital read, add my switch as argument, and then compare it with the value 0 by using the equal sign. By doing that, every time the function digital read checks the signal that comes from the switch, it will return 0 when the switch is connected to the ground level. On the other hand, it will return 1 when the switch is connected to 5 volts. Based on that, when the switch is to the left, which means ground level in our circuit, I want to keep the LED off. In this case, we're going to use the digital write function. And we're going to put the parameter low to turn off the LED. On the other hand, if the switch is to the right, I want to turn on my LED, so I'm going to use a new command inside the else conditional. I'm going to turn on our LED using the digital write function with the parameter high. So, in summary, what we did was, we named our pins here using the command define. And then, in the void setup, we configured each pin as input or output. And finally, in the void loop, we used the conditional if else to turn on and off the LED. Based on that, if the switch is to the left, which means ground level, I want to turn my LED off. Otherwise, I want to turn it on. All right, let's test our code. Let me close the code tab and start the simulation. Note that the LED is off. But once I change the switch to the right, which means sending 5 volts to pin 13, the programming logic will turn the LED on. And if we change the switch to the left, the LED is turned off. Now, let's use the same logic to test the button circuit. Bear in mind that we're going to need to make a few changes in our code, because when the button is not pressed, I am sending 5 volts to pin 12. You can double check in the beginning of this video, how does the button circuit work? Based on that, when we have 5 volts on pin 12, the LED should be off. And when I press the button, I am sending a ground level to pin 12, and then, I want to turn on the LED. To do that, let's go to our code, and the first thing I'm going to do is to change the pin name, because now, we're going to use the button as input. So, when the button is pressed, which means sending ground level to pin 12, I want to turn on the LED. And when we have 5 volts on pin 12, which means the button is not pressed, I want to turn off the LED. By doing these small changes, we guarantee that the circuit is going to work the way we expect. So, basically, when the button is sending a ground level to pin 12, or if the button is pressed, I turn on the LED, otherwise, I turn off the LED. So, let's test our code. Note that the LED is turned off, and the button is not pressed. When I press the button, the LED turns on. And as long as I keep it pressed, the LED is on. Before we finish our tutorial, I'd like to highlight some key points about using an Arduino board. We could see that the operation of our circuit will depend not only on the connections that we made on the breadboard, but also depends on the programming logic that we develop. We could see that by using two different circuits, we could control the LED illumination. If you still have questions about how to use the digital input of the Arduino board, please send us a message on the comments. I hope you have enjoyed. See you on the next video, and thank you for your support. Take care.